For the rest of this and next, we're going to be talking about discriminative methods for doing recognition or classification. By the way, I'll probably use those words interchangeably, classification, recognition, probably a little sloppy of me because we talked a little bit about the difference. I'm just basically talking about classifying something as being an A or a B, or even more precisely, an A or a not A. Before we go forward, we're going to make some assumptions, okay? Our first assumption, we're going to assume that there's a fixed number of known classes, right? So I'm going to tell you there are four things in this universe you have to worry about. Now, they might be A's, B's, C's, and none of the above, but it's not like later I'm going to give you some D's, or later I'm going to give you some E's. No, I'm going to tell you the classes that exist a priori. So when I train this system and I'm defining the boundaries, I'm only worrying about the classes that you tell me in advance that I know about. The other thing I'm going to assume is that I've got plenty of data. I've got training examples that come from this class, and it might not be, shall we say, that data hard, you know, I've got an exponential amount, but I've got lots of data, so it's possible for me to typically find points that tend to be, you know, might get confused with some other class. For the conversations we're going to have today and the next time, we're going to assume an equal cost of mistakes. So it costs you just as much to call an A a not A as it does to call a not A an A. In fact, one of the methods we'll talk about the fact that some of the distributions might be quite asymmetric, right? So you might be looking for, say, I don't know, faces. We're going to do that one. In an image, and you may know that most places in an image, in most images, are not faces. So you might take advantage of that fact in terms of how you search for them, but we're not going to worry about the relative cost. Remember that loss function between making the two kinds of mistakes. And the other thing is that we're going to assume is that, and this is actually good because it's true, it's always good to assume true things, we need to build a representation of each instance, so we're going to build a description, but we don't know a priori what features actually matter. So we're going to write down a whole bunch of things about each instance, and then we're going to train a discriminative classifier to make the distinction, the classification, and it'll have to figure out where the information is in the feature. All right, so that's a lot of assuming, but I'm good at making assumptions.